up until the late 1800s, patients would be conscious during surgical procedures and experience excruciating pain. Thankfully, as we all know, anesthesia has made even the most complicated surgeries tolerable as well as much safer. Our good friend and colleague, Dr. Freda Lewis-Hall, the Chief Medical Officer of Pfizer, is back today to help answer some of your questions about anesthesia. Welcome, I'm glad we're talking about this.
Thank you, absolutely. Lots of questions,
there absolutely are. So, Dr. Freda, one of our viewers sent us this particular question. Let's have a look.
Hey, Doc, my name's Jordan Service. I don't understand how you can cut somebody open and they don't feel any pain. How does anesthesia work?
So, there are a number of different types of anesthesia. Today we're going to talk about general anesthesia, which is usually used for pain control and for sedation in major surgeries. Now, it affects the entire body and it prevents the brain from processing pain.
Which is important because an anesthetized brain doesn't respond to pain signals. General anesthesia causes the brain to be brought to a level of unconsciousness where there is no sensation or memory of what happened, which most people want when they're going in for surgery.
Yep, that's right. That is the goal of general anesthesia. And it's usually administered in combination. And this combination is injected into the vein and inhaled as a gas through a breathing mask. And the combination includes, first of all, a sedative to relax you, a narcotic for pain management, and a hypnotic to reduce your awareness of the surgery.
Speaking of surgery, we received this question also from another viewer.
Hi, docs. My name is Chanel, and I heard that you could wake up in the middle of a medical procedure. Is this true?
It is very rare because anesthesiologists are present during surgery. They're monitoring patients' blood pressure, pulse, and breathing, and can adjust medications as needed. But yes, research has shown that one or two patients out of 10,000 may become conscious while under general anesthesia.
Yes, and this is sometimes referred to as anesthesia awareness. And the patient may become aware or recall their surroundings during surgery or an event related to their surgery, but they usually do not experience or feel the pain.
Which is the most important
thing. Which is the important part.
And I do want to go to one more viewer, Peyton, who emailed us and wanted to know, how do you know how much anesthesia to give a patient so they don't wake up? People seem to be really nervous about waking up during surgery. Peyton happens to be here today so she can get an answer in person. Peyton, welcome.
Thank you. Hi.
Great to have you.
Yeah.
And Peyton, in order to get the correct amount of anesthesia, a number of things are taken into consideration. Your age, your weight, your gender, whether you have other medications that you take, and whether or not the patient is experiencing any other illnesses. Is there a specific concern that you have?
Well, yeah, my dad, who I brought with me, Neil, is gonna have knee replacement surgery in a couple months, so I'm just kinda curious.
Well, Neil, first of all, good luck with it, but since you're here and your daughter is worried about you, anything you wanna ask?
Well, with that kind of surgery, I am a little concerned, and is there anything I should do prior to the surgery to prepare?
Before the surgery, do discuss your medical history with your healthcare team. You can include any allergies, medications, or supplements you may be taking. Certainly, if you smoke, you want to tell your treatment team, because the one thing is these factors, all of them can impact the effectiveness of the anesthesia that you're going to receive. You also want to know how soon before surgery you should stop eating and drinking, and you want to also talk to your doc about what schedule for the medicines you may be taking and how that may change with surgery coming up.
And there are a couple of things for after the procedure as well. Some people experience headaches, nausea, muscle aches, and some confusion. Now, these side effects are usually temporary, but if you have any questions or concerns, talk to your doctor. Anesthesia can stay in your body for up to 24 hours. And so you shouldn't drive, but instead plan on having a family member or a friend make sure that you get home safely. And I see you have a volunteer already.
Yeah. And it's also good because having someone around you for 24 hours or so after anesthesia is important. Again, I think your bases are covered, Neil.
I hope so.
If you have questions about general anesthesia or about the other forms of anesthesia, local and regional, ask your doctor, or you can always visit gethealthystayhealthy.com. And while you're there, you can sign up for our monthly newsletter.
Good luck with the surgery, Neil.
Thank you.
More to come, everyone.